Alrighty, what's going on? Welcome back to the channel. Today is going to be a little bit of a different video. So me and Ben went out and purchased ourselves a TIG welder. We got the flashy Unimig razor welder. It's a 200 amp AC-DC TIG welder. Neither of us barely know how to MIG weld, but we thought we'd go out and buy a TIG welder, because why not? It's just another thing we want to learn how to do so we can fabricate all our own stuff on all our cars. So why not just buy one and then just practice, especially with all this COVID-19 bullshit going on. If we get locked down, we're going to be in here practicing the TIG weld. Ben's 180's been pushed in the shed. It's getting some work done. He's stitch welded the shut towers and the inside. Getting her all welded up. Getting her ready for paint. Getting there. This thing's going to be getting a dirty LS now. He was originally thinking RB, but now she's going to get a dirty LS. Not much room in here with three cars. So we bought the TIG welder last night and obviously couldn't help but set her up and have a dip. So here are our boogers. We got some 3mm stainless here. That was the first one. It wants the focus. And then, yeah, just get the lighting better. Just boogers on boogers. Some of them actually came out like half decent, like them there. But then like, these are the last ones we did. It's just like, that was Ben's mate half, but yeah. She's it's quite a steep learning curve, but keen as to actually get decent at this and be able to weld stainless and aluminium. Right, now we just cut up a heap of little stainless strips. It's like, how thick's this? Oh, 1.5mm thick stainless. I'm just gonna tack them together like that. It's a bit warped because we cut it off that sheet there. So it's all a bit warped and here you go on, but tack them on there, clean up these edges, and then try to lay some fat beads there, and then we'll just flip it over and do the same thing on the back where it joins. So, how many did I cut? Didn't cut an even number. Nice. Yeah, gonna get this set up, get ready to go, and try lay some beads and see how we progress along each bit of stainless. We're using a tungsten that's actually too thick for what we're doing. It's the one that came with the torch. And then the ones I bought, which I've snapped and sharpened, they're actually too thin for the thing inside the torch to grab. So we need to get a new thing inside the torch to grab so we can grab the size that's actually supposed to be used with this steel. So these are 1.6mm tungstens. They're used for like your thinner stuff. This is a 2.4mm tungsten, which according to the machine, so we've got the tungsten setting set on 2.4, and then our amperage is set on 40 because of the 1.5mm stainless we're welding, and it's coming up with this parameter warning because when you've got a 2.4mm tungsten, it once says you should be at over 70. So when you go over 70, the warning goes away. So you should really be at over 70 amps for a 2.4mm tungsten, but just gotta make it work. So we'll get these cleaned up and then see what we can make of it. Just got rid of all the burrs on these bits of stainless on the upside down.
Bell
sand, that's the one. We had a bench sander over there, but we got it given to us and the motor's like burnt out and starts smoking all the time. So had to give that the arse. We'll have to get one eventually, but this thing does the trick. Tied them up. So yeah, you can try tack them together like that. See if we can get some fat little beads in there. It's only thin shit, but something to practice on. Oh, I'm gonna see if I can tack these bits together. Oh, I just stuck it. There's melted one of them.
Yeah, I guess some filler in there.
Yeah, no good. Absolutely fucking no good. completely missed. I need to be in a better spot because you need to hold the torch like on an angle in between the two of them. That's sort of not cutting it, that posy.
Well, that didn't work. Try again.
Surely that was better. Oh yeah. That was much better. That was better. I've got the torch on a better angle to both bits of steel then. It's sort of working a bit better. Really got to get in the right position. That's alright, I'm happy with that. That's sick, that's the first two bits of metal I tried to weld together.
Well, apart from I tried to weld that pipe together last night. I'll show you this.
It just did not work.
Yeah, that was no good. Wasn't quite ready to attack that. It was a nice little one. That's not nice. But yeah, that was something.
But that, I'm happy with that. Let's do another one like that.
Ah, that's hot.
Well, yeah, that second go there was no good, but see if I can bring it back.
Oh, fucking dog. Stop it.
First bit started off good and then turned to shit. I reckon I dirtied the tungsten and that's just completely cooked the rest of it. Like, I reckon, whoa, focus, you piece of shit. I reckon that's enough to dirty it. It's a bit too hot to touch, isn't it?
Compared to, where's the clean one?
That, I reckon. That's what it started like. And that's what it finished like. I reckon you gotta keep it real clean.
Oh, I'll throw the other one in and see what Ben can whip out another bit of steel.
That's what I got.
Does it square, mate? Over a meal, ish.
We're sticking the tungsten out of the torch about the same diameter as the cup, which is what I've seen someone say online, so send it.
Go with that.
Go with that. This table's gonna be getting wrapped in steel, but it's not wrapped in steel yet, so we got a makeshift little metal plate to work on. So tried welding on this and it burnt straight through onto the table.
Good feeler for the tack, or did you just go with it?
If you get it on the right angle, it'll be fine. If you shoot it on that 45 in between the two bits of steel, it should tack. But when I tried to tack it with no feeler, I was just on the one bit of steel.
Do you want to hit the lights so I can see?
Yeah. You probably want to move your hand sideways. You try and move it to, yeah. Need a welding helmet for the camera. Boy, I just looked at that. That wasn't good.
Oh, he's touched it.
Yeah. Again.
He's got up there and again.
Oh, do you know fucking what it is?
fucking.
I swear I touched that. Oh, no, what's going on there?
What are you going
to
say about them?
Oh, not a lot. You get one good one. It goes up the shit. It's not me. It's the stainless.
What am I doing wrong here?
Sort of missed. Nah, more accurate.
Flat out,
alright, so we're back out in the shed. The other night we sort of just got distracted and had enough and called it a night, but we're out here to do some more TIG welding. So I've gone to the shops, bought a couple of little goodies. I've got a short little end because I saw it in there, as I can see. So that'll screw in the back and reduce the size of the torch a fair bit. Might come in handy when we're trying to get into our spots or something. I don't know. I just thought it was cool. TIG torch mods. And then I got a different collet body, I think they call it. So this one that came with the torch, and this one that came with the torch, is made to hold 2.4mm tungsten. So these bigger ones, like that. And then the one I bought, this one allows us to put in the little 1.6mm tungstens, which is actually the size you're supposed to be using for this thinner metal here, 1.5mm. So you're going to put that in, put a little short knobby on, and we also got some purple tungstens. Damo, the gun fabricator, who's given us some tips and advice. Cheers, Damo. And he said, purple tungsten, we'll throw them in the bin. So we've got some purple, see how that goes. And we're gonna try with some little 1.6s, see how that goes. So probably break them down to fit in there, because now we're gonna be running the shorter end. Sharpen a few up and see if we can get the hang of things. Alright, I've decided I'm not ready to weld something together. I'm going to practice just doing some lines for now. Oh, I've been trying to do some just lines on some bit of stainless. So all these ones you can see that aren't from the other side. Starting to get there. Starting to look alright. Practicing the basics. Where's that other bit of metal? Take a couple butt joins on this thing. And that one in the middle there was my efforts. Oh, it does not want to focus. Sorry again. There you go, that's better. Yeah, getting there. Cut some pipe, then just tacked it together. This little joint here, so we're gonna have a dip at welding pipe if we can't help ourselves. Missed. We've done a couple of joints and some pipe. It didn't come out too bad. Definitely some boogers on there, but for what it is, we're getting there. I think that's alright considering. definitely seen better before, but can't complain with their current experience on the TIG. With a bit more practice, you make an exhaust and shit in no time. That's the first joining pipe that we tried to do. You look at that. I'd say that's a pretty good improvement so far. Take that. Yeah, that's probably gonna conclude this little video of us learning to TIG weld. If you wanna see more videos like this, let us know in the comments down below. We'd definitely be keen to make more as we journey into the TIG world. Probably be pretty keen to maybe make a welding bench or table or something with it, and then just start whipping out dump pipes and exhaust, intercooler pipes, start fabbing shit. Yeah, hope you enjoyed it. Smack the like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll see you in the next video. It's time you're checking on yourself. Fuck.